Hey everyone, I am Kanaya Gupta and today I am gonna show you how to solve Equalize the Array Hackering problem. In this problem, Carl has an array of integers. He wants to reduce the array until all remaining elements are equal. Determine the minimum number of elements to delete to reach his goal. For example, so in the sample input, n equals to 5, which is the number of elements present in the array, and these are the 5 elements. Now our task is to identify the minimum number of deletion such that all elements present inside the array should be of same type. So if we delete 2 and 1 from the array, you can see all elements are of same type inside the array, which is 3. So the answer is 2. Why? Because we have to delete at least minimum of 2 elements from the array, so such that all elements will remain same inside the array. So this is the problem, guys. You have given an array and you have to delete minimum number of elements such that all elements present inside the array after the deletion are same. Let's build the logic around it. Guys, I have taken one example here. So in that we have 6, which is the number of elements present in the array. And after that we have 6 elements. Let's see what are the different combinations are possible from this input. Suppose from this input we are deleting 1, 2, another 2. So once we delete that, so only 3 will be left. So after deleting 3 elements, we can mention here in a bracket 3 element, we'll get the array of same type. Now let's take another one. In this, if we will delete 1, 4 element from the array, so we will have array of 2s, which is of same type. So this is also one of a valid case. Now the third one we have, if we delete 2, -3, -3, -3, which is 5. So now we have array of 1 and all elements are same. So these are the 3 valid output, guys. So now we have to tell the minimum number of deletion. Here you can see we have deleted 3 elements in the first case. In the second one we have deleted 4. In the third one we have deleted 5 elements to reach this final state. But our task is to identify the minimum number of deletion required such that all elements present inside the array after the deletion are same. So you can see 3, 4, 5, the minimum number of element or deletion required is 3. So in our case, answer will be 3. From the array, we have to delete at least 3 elements such that all remaining elements present inside the array are same. So this is the problem, guys. Now if you talk about the solution, we can easily say, as we know, we have to delete the minimum number of elements, which is only possible when the maximum number of elements are already same inside the array. So from the array, we have to calculate what are the maximum number of elements which are same. So we will leave that element as it is and delete the rest one. So take this array again, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, and we will count the number of frequencies or occurrences of that element. So if you see, 1 is 1 time, 2 is 2 times, and 3 is 3 times. So now we have a frequency with us. So these are the frequencies. So 1 is 1 time, 2 is 2 times, 3 is 3 times. Now once we have a frequency, we will see which element occurs maximum times. So if you see, the maximum frequency is this. Third or 3 element occurs maximum number of time, which is 3. Among all the frequencies, 3 is the highest one. So 3 occurs 3 times, you can see. So it means we have to leave 3 as it is, because at the end this should be present. And rest we have to delete. We have to delete all occurrences of 1, all occurrences of 2. So if you remove all occurrences, how many occurrences we have? 1 and 2. So total we have 3 occurrences. So we have to delete 3 occurrences from the array. So we have total number of element, which is 6, and from total element subtract the maximum frequency from this total number of elements. Now we'll get 3. So it means the total of 1 plus 2 is 3. So we have to delete minimum of 3 element from the array to achieve this goal. I hope guys this is clear to you how we are going to solve this problem. Let's see the algorithm in action guys. This is the method guys, equalizing the array. So in that I am accepting array as a parameter. First I have calculated the length of the array, and the second I am taking an auxiliary array and initializing this array with 101. Why I have initialized this array with 101? Because if you go to the HackerRank and see the constraint, n will be in a range of 1 to 100 and all array element also will be in the range of 1 to 100. As we know, array starts from 0 onwards, so we have to take 101 because all 100 elements from 1 to 100 and from array starts from 0 onwards, so we have to take 101. So now we have in this for loop, we are taking each and every element from the array, and inside auxiliary array we are maintaining the frequency count. Once this array maintain all the frequency count, after that we are sending this array or passing this array to a method which is called getMaxFrequencyCount. So in this method we are accepting an array and just calculating the maximum frequency. So it's simply like we are just taking a for loop. So in this method we are just calculating the maximum element from the array, nothing else. So once you get the maximum frequency count, we are returning that from the array, and finally we are subtracting that maximum frequency count from the total length of the array, because we know this is a maximum frequency count which should not be deleted from the array. So finally it should be present in the array, so we are deleting that maximum frequency count from the total length of the array, and after that whatever it comes, it means that element we have to delete from the array. I hope guys it's clear to you. Let's run this program in a HackerRank platform. Sample test case got passed. Congratulations guys, all tests has got passed now. If you need the source code, you can go to my GitHub repository and download the source code from there, and the link is mentioned in the description box. Thanks for watching guys, and let me know if you have any good approach to solve this problem.